Hello.
Hola.
Hello. Gabriella, are you Gabriella?
Yes.
Hey, nice to meet you. Nice to meet you.
I'm fine, thanks.
Shake hands. So where are you, Gabriella? Where are you? Hi, Raja.
Hi.
We have Gabriella here already with us.
From Mexico, right?
Yes.
Have you joined earlier, Gabriella? Have you tried to join earlier?
Can you hear us, Gabriella? Are you eating chocolate, Raja? Hey, Judy. Hey, it's Conrado as well. Hi, Conrado.
Hi. Hi, Nick.
How are you?
Hi, everybody. I'm fine.
Hi, Conrado.
Hi.
Adam was asleep.
Raja.
He just woke up. Hi.
We've got Gabriella here. Is your name Gabriella? Right?
Not chocolate.
Gabriella?
I think she can't hear us now.
Can you not hear us, Gabriella? And who else do we have? D93177. Is that your real name? No.
It's a robot.
Hello.
Hello.
Hello. What's your name?
Hello. Good morning. Hi. My name is Danny.
Danny?
Yeah.
And where are you in the world, Danny?
Yes, of course, I'm from Mexico.
Mexico.
Yeah.
Fantastic. Really nice to meet you, Danny.
Yes, of course, yeah. I'm very nervous for this class because Murphy's Day about in this class.
You're very nervous?
Yeah.
Don't be nervous.
It's not a class whatsoever.
They're very friendly sheep. The sheep are very friendly.
Yeah.
They don't bite.
Perfect, thank you.
Thank you so much. Wow, we've got lots of people joining us now. We've got Kanduk here as well. Hi, Kanduk. We can't hear you.
Hello, hi,
hear my kid.
Hello.
Hello.
And we've got Sue here as well.
Hello.
Hi, Sue.
Hi.
Happy Easter.
Happy Easter.
Danny, can you change your name, please? Or shall I change it?
Yes, of course. Can you repeat, please?
Is it D-A-N-I? Like that? Is that right? Is that correct? Danny, can you please speak to Gabriella? Because I don't think she can. I'm not sure if she's on her own or is she with her family or.
Okay, yes, of course. Okay, so I repeat all the information. Yeah. My name is Danny. I'm from Mexico. In this moment, I am very nervous because it's my first class.
Okay.
Very, very nervous for you.
But I should tell you, this isn't a class. This isn't a class. This is just a way to connect different families around the world. Okay, so how about we do a quick, what should we do, Raja? Shall we do a quick introduction of everyone?
It's overcrowded here, just give me a second. Hi, sorry guys, I have twins here, they're very active. Say hi, say hi, hi.
Hello guys.
Hi, say hello.
Hello. Hello.
Adam, say hi.
Hi.
So, this is Adam.
Adam.
This is Adam, okay? This is Adam.
Hi, Adam.
Adam.
Those are twins, like 2 years.
Uh-huh.
And this is my eldest, Salma.
Hi, Salma.
Hello.
And this is Alma.
Hi, my name is Alma.
Hi, Alma.
Hi.
Judy is like, she's, come. This is
Judy. Hi, Judy.
So that's enough of me.
Okay, brilliant.
2 years now.
Thanks a lot, Raja. So Raja is our coordinator in Gaza, if you don't know that. How do I say your name? Khan.
Khanduk. It's exactly as it is.
Khanduk.
Yeah.
Great. Do you want to introduce yourself? Khanduk?
Yeah, I'm Khanduk. This is, say your name. This is Sean.
Sean.
Hello, Sean.
Hi, Sean.
Sean's five. And this is?
I'm Poppy.
And Poppy is 11. Poppy just turned 11 last week.
Happy birthday, Poppy.
So we live in Germany.
Yeah.
And it's 12 o'clock here now.
Absolutely.
Yeah. Brilliant.
Where do you live in Germany?
We live in a small town called Hennef, and that's near Bonn. So it's in the west.
I have some relatives living in Germany. I have my cousin, she lives in Berlin. I have my uncle, he lives in Kiel, a city that is called Kiel.
Yes, Kiel is on the coast. Yeah, Kiel is on the coast. Kiel and Berlin are very far away from us, about 5 hours on the train.
Yeah.
Very nice.
Lovely. Okay, great. Thank you so much, Khanduk. Okay, so we go to Danny. Shall we go to Danny then? Let's go to Danny in Mexico.
Yeah, Mexico City. But in this moment, my daughter is asleep. But in a moment.
Don't wake her up.
Yes, because in this moment in Mexico City, the hour is the 5 a.m.
Oh,
it's 5 in the morning.
Yeah, the morning. Yeah.
Thank you for making time for this and for coming. Thank you.
You're welcome. It's okay. Thank you so much.
We wish you up.
That's brilliant. So you have just one daughter?
My daughter have 5 years old.
Yeah.
I'm... وين كيف اسمه مني؟
أعطيهم حاجات إنهم يطلعين برا. Yes.
It's impossible. It's impossible in this moment because very late.
Yeah, yeah. Don't wake her up.
For sure. Yeah.
Let us sleep. Okay, fantastic.
It's
okay. Great. Shall we go back to? Thanks a lot, Danny. Lovely to meet you. Shall we go back to Sahar in Gaza?
Yeah. Hello. Hello, everyone.
Hello.
I am Sahar. This is my family. Hello.
Hi, Mahmoud. Hi.
This is my daughter, Layan.
Layan.
My niece. This is my niece, Sham. Sham lives with us in the same building. Her mother is a teacher. She's working in the noon shift. Until her mother comes back home, she stays with us. And this is my son, Mahmoud.
Hi,
Mahmoud.
Hi, Mahmoud.
Mahmoud moves faster than a machine.
Really?
Oh, my goodness.
And this is my son, Muhammad.
Hi, Muhammad.
He's crazy about football. I'm sorry that you are crowded here. beside each other because my laptop had broken, so I joined from my mobile.
Okay.
It's okay, Sahar. I'm even more crowded than you are.
Well, at least you've got children. I'm crowded with sheep. I've got sheep.
This is Mahmoud. We brought Mahmoud for the sake of Raja. Mahmoud is Raja's friend.
Mahmoud is like my best friend.
He finds her in the street and walks with her.
He always walks with me because they live near the school I work, so I see him. When he sees me, we just walk together. He goes home and just...
Brilliant, brilliant. All right, fantastic. Let's go to... Where should we go now? Brazil. Let's go to Brazil.
Hi, everyone. My name is Conrado. Okay. And I don't know if you see me well. I can see myself to the... I mean, I can see myself not clearly.
We can see you. We can see you really clearly. We can see that you haven't had a shave today.
No, no. I'm sorry. I'm really sorry for that. Thank you. Well, I live in the south of Brazil, and now it's 7 o'clock in the morning, 7:10 in the morning. Okay.
That's very early in this.
That's moment. Yeah. That's why I didn't have a shave.
We forgive you. We forgive you.
Thanks.
Now we'll go to Sue in England as well.
Yeah. Hello, everyone. Hello.
Hello.
I'm in Manchester in the UK. And it's a beautiful day here today. It's about 10 past 11. It's a beautiful day. Usually it's raining in Manchester. But today it's beautiful. I have got my daughter is here, but she's just having her breakfast because she's just got up. She's a teenager, a lazy teenager. maybe she'll join us soon.
Okay, brilliant.
Your t-shirt, Sue. What's it called? Your t-shirt.
Oh, this is my Big Ride t-shirt.
Can you show it to us?
Yeah, because I've finished my cycle rides. Every weekend I do a cycle ride of 22 miles. Wow. So this weekend I finished. I did it for 7 weekends.
Wow.
She's even better than you, Nick.
Yeah.
Lovely.
Oh, the big ride.
Fantastic. Fantastic. One day we'll do it together in Palestine one day.
Yeah.
That would be lovely.
Definitely, yeah.
Finger crossed.
Okay, let's go to Gabriela then, also in Mexico, yeah?
Where is she? Can't see her.
Here's Gabriela.
Hi.
My kids are just saying hi. Say hi.
Gabriela.
Hi.
How old are you, Gabriela?
Hello, we are from Mexico City.
Uh-huh.
Here it is very early right now.
Yeah.
It is 5 in the morning.
Wow. Are you tired? Are you tired? That's great that you got up at 5 in the morning. Fantastic.
My kids are loving it.
Okay, great. So that's everyone, isn't it? Everyone's introduced themselves. Oh, I haven't introduced myself. My name's Nick.
Someone.
What?
The other Sahar, where is she?
I don't think she's here.
She's not here. Okay.
She's not here. So my name's Nick, and I'm in a place called Totnes in Devon, in the southwest of England. Okay, great. So, Raja, who's going to go first with the Oh My Home thing?
That's a very hard decision to make. I mean, whoever wants to go first, I guess. I can't pick. You go first. You brought this to yourself, yeah. Come on, yalla, you go first. Yeah.
All right, then. Well, what I'm going to do, so this is about talking about something that represents home for us, okay? And I'm going to show you something. I'm going to cheat, actually.
There you go.
Okay, can you see my background?
Yes.
Okay.
Yeah, great.
This girl who is from Gaza, her name is Zainab, isn't it, Sahar?
Yeah, Zainab.
And 4 years ago today, she did something amazing. She was in Gaza in the UNRWA field office, and she was performing a play to about 200 people in Scotland. And she was performing it remotely. She was performing it through Zoom with her friends. And it's a play that is a traditional Palestinian story called Jebene. It's a bit like Cinderella.
Yes.
And she, this is the moment when she went right up to the audience. This person here is the prince. Whoops, this is the prince. No, the landowner. And he asked her to marry him. And Jebena, or Zainab, she went up to the webcam and she said to the audience, "What do you think? Should I marry him?" And the audience said, mostly yes, because they're all very romantic. And she did marry him. But this was the first ever performance of remote theatre by the Hands Up Project.
Yes.
And it was 4 years ago today. You remember it, Sahar?
Yeah, it was in Glasgow.
Exactly.
Yes.
Exactly. So, and that was Sahar's student. So Sahar has been with the Hands Up Project for a very long time. And she's done some amazing work, and we're very, very proud of her and your students.
Thank you.
Your kids should be so proud of you too. Are your kids proud of you, Sahar?
Let me ask them.
Let's ask them.
Yes. Yes. They say yes.
Brilliant. Okay, so it's not really about my home. It's about children in Palestine talking about their home. But in a way, I feel like Palestine is my home now. I feel
that's
like
right, it's my home. Nick. It's your home, and you are proud that you are one of us, and we consider you one of the Palestinian family. Feel free to share whatever you like about our children and our students.
Thank you.
It's your second home, yes.
Okay, so let's go to you then, Sahar, now. Your turn. What are you going to show us?
Yeah, if we talk about Palestine, there are many things to show and to represent. Actually, I prepared a video about Musakhan, Palestinian food, but it's on my laptop, but I can't open it. I don't know what's the problem with it. So here I have a small piece of ceramics. You know, Palestine is famous for traditional crafts.
Uh-huh.
It's traditional for ceramics and wooden things and things that's made from wicker. And also we say bamboo about wicker. Do you know wicker?
Yeah.
Wicker.
Yeah.
Bamboo.
Long, thin
wood. And this piece in my hand, it's a telephone. It's handmade in Palestine. This is a piece of ceramics. It's clearly.
Lovely, yeah.
Yeah. I always buy these things and put them in my house. And if any one of my kids is near to them, I make a trouble. because they can be broken any time.
Yeah.
Also, I have a wallet. Uh-huh. This is a wallet. It's a piece of embroidery. You know about embroidery. You know embroidery?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, we use strings of silk. Silk strings that are colorful. And they can make many patterns. This is a pattern of a strawberry. I don't know if it's clear.
Mm-hmm.
And they use, they make many things of embroidery, like wallets, sometimes plates, sometimes dresses. I see Rajaa is wearing a Palestinian dress, which is embroidered from head to toe.
Oh, Sahar's here now. Yeah, the other Sahar's here. Hi, Sahar.
Mm-hmm.
Hi, Sahar.
Hi. How are you?
So we got.
Hello, Sahar.
Sorry for being late.
That's okay. We just started.
Hi, everybody.
Hello, Sahar.
Hello.
Yeah, we can hear you. Yes.
Okay, so Salha, that's brilliant. Thank you for sharing that with us.
Thanks. You're welcome.
Hello. What should we do now, Raja? Where should we go now?
Move to someone like from Mexico, like Danny, maybe.
Do you want to do something, Danny? Have you got something to show us?
Yes, of course. Yeah.
Thank you.
Well, about Mexico City, about interesting, a lot there. There are a lot of things. I don't know, maybe. The most interesting in Mexico City, it's a lot of things, but in special it's about of the food. It's very delicious in Mexico City, about the tacos. It's very, very delicious. About tacos, quesadillas. The quesadillas, it's about a cheese, only the cheese, about the meat, about the a lot of So all the thing about the Mexico City, it's about the museums. It's very interesting. So about of the, well, really it's very interesting, all the things in Mexico City, but in especially, I think that is the food, yeah. About the tacos and quesadillas, the most interesting for me, yeah, for me.
Brilliant.
Yeah. Yes.
Anybody want to ask Danny anything or?
Thank
yes,
you.
Yes, please. Yes. I want to ask something.
Go on.
Okay. So, Danny, my daughters watch a lot of cartoons, and in this cartoon, they see that taco is like a meal to be eaten. They are crazy about it, and they want me to make them taco. And I, frankly, I don't know how to make it. So can you just very simply tell us what is it?
There is only the meat, and if you, I like with, I don't know, with meat, with onion, with cilantro. Yeah.
Coriander.
Yeah.
Cilantro is coriander. You know coriander?
And onion, yeah.
So it's wrapped in a bread or something? Is it in bread?
Yes, of course. Maybe, yeah.
Mm-hmm. Is it different than
tortilla? It's similar. It's about this. It's similar. It's the same, but it's similar.
Okay.
Brilliant. That's great. Okay, fantastic. Shall we go to...
Thank you.
Thanks a lot, Danny. Shall we go to Germany? Shall we go to Hamburg?
Sean wants to show something.
Brilliant.
Sean has something. Sean's going to show
Oh, my goodness.
Putzi. And Putzi has been with Sean since Sean was born.
Wow.
Really?
And Poppy has something. Poppy loves art. And Poppy did this at primary school. She did that last year. We've been in lockdown since March last year.
Yeah.
So Poppy didn't have a primary school leaving, and there was a lot of work that they'd done alone and online, and this is her memory.
Wow. Can you show it, Poppy? Can you show it really close to the webcam? Can you tell us about it, Poppy? Can you tell us about the picture?
I don't know how you did it.
We had to use geometric shapes like square and triangle.
Mm-hmm.
Like I have a square there, but we also had to use
The thing that you use to draw circles. What's that called? I've forgotten now.
A protractor.
A protractor.
Sorry. No. A compass.
A compass, yeah.
Make the circuit, and it had to be very neat.
Uh-huh.
And beautiful. When we had to colour it in, it was a bit trickier because I had to fill in every shape, and I made a lot of shapes.
Wow.
What paints did you use? Did you use paint? She used acrylic paints for that.
Acrylic paint. It's so bright and colourful, isn't it? It's amazing, the colours.
Beautiful.
Yeah. And this is about lockdown then, is it, Poppy?
Mm-hmm.
This is like your experience of lockdown.
Yeah.
Wow. Can you take a picture of that and send it?
Yeah, we'll send it to you.
It's so lovely.
Yeah.
It's just amazing the things you do just with geometric shapes. So
yeah.
All, where is it? I'm not good at this. See these here, these semi, yeah, you do that. The semi, they're all done with the compass. So, you know, it's not free.
Yeah.
Free art and the stairs.
Wow.
Yeah.
How long did it take you to make that picture, Poppy?
About 3 weeks.
3 weeks, yeah. Great.
Can we ask something? I've seen that you are asking all the questions.
Yeah, sorry. I've got a tendency to dominate everything. So, I need to keep my mouth shut.
So I can feel that there are a lot of circles. Do they mean that they are bubbles, maybe?
Maybe, I don't know.
Yeah.
I just
use them. And what is inside them? Can you just explain that? Sorry?
I did more squares inside because I thought that looked really nice.
And I can see a stair or something. Stairs, is that a stairs? It's a creative piece.
It's really. Just creative. I think that was a moment of creativity during during hard lockdown a year ago.
The combination of colors are just amazing.
Yeah.
The things at the bottom look a bit like lollipops.
What?
Yeah.
Yes.
The bottom look a bit like big, great big lollipops. Yeah.
Yeah.
You feel like eating it.
It looks like some weird Willy Wonka thing, doesn't it?
Exactly. Charlie and the Chocolate Factory. Yeah. Brilliant.
Yeah.
Brilliant.
Just gloop.
Yeah.
Shall we go to the other Saha now? Thank you so much, Poppy and Sean and Handuk, for sharing that. Shall we go to the other Saha? Because you haven't had a chance to speak yet.
Yes. First of all, I'm so sorry for being late for this session, but because, you know, I've just come from my school and look at me, I'm just wearing my mask and everything. So I was just in a rush to come and see the people here and to know more about the other people. And today, because there we have three and maybe four, if we consider Mr. Nick as a Palestinian people, and I know that all of them talked a lot about Palestine, I prefer to play a Palestinian game with you. So if you can get just a paper and a pen, that will be fine.
Okay.
Raja, I need your help because I need a timer.
Yes, I'm bringing a paper. I've just brought a paper. I'm so excited, like it's
nice.
Go on.
Raja, I want to set a timer for 30 seconds only.
Okay.
I've got this.
What's that?
30 seconds?
Wait, 1 minute.
Can
we use that?
Okay. Yeah. Okay, 1 minute. Okay, deal.
All right, then.
Okay.
What do we have to do?
The whole issue is about I want you all to name something that starts with the letter, and I will tell you what is the letter later, okay?
Okay.
But what are the things? I need a name of a boy.
Yeah.
You can write that down, please.
Yeah.
A boy. A girl.
Yeah.
An object.
Okay.
Plant.
Yeah.
An animal. And a country.
Okay.
All these things should start with the letter. What about starting with the letter S?
S. Okay, should I start the time?
Yes, please.
Okay, 1 minute, starting now.
Okay.
So only the name or last name?
First name. Yeah. First name.
The whole list, yes, 1 minute, yeah.
Okay, thank you.
Okay, go.
Finish.
No, Sahar.
That was quick.
Yeah, this is not fair.
You've I'm started the judge here. I don't want to play with you. Okay, Sahar.
Go on then, Sahar. You've still got 20 seconds left.
Let them write down something.
I'm sorry that you don't know how brilliant I am, Mr. May.
That is falling apart.
You play that in Arabic a lot. And yes. I know that you wrote Arabic names. So you should change them into English names.
No.
Start with this.
No.
No, I wrote Arabic names as well.
Do you think I can play this name without
writing? Okay, 1 minute finished.
Oh my goodness, I don't remember. It's about the letter and gear or boy, yeah?
Yeah.
And next step, I don't know, I don't remember. Yeah. An object, an animal, and country.
Yeah. And a plant.
Plant. Ah, okay, plant.
Yes, I want to hear from all of you. Let's start with Sahar. Who has finished first?
Okay. The boy is Sam.
Yeah.
The girl is Sahar.
Uh-huh.
The object, I have two objects actually. Sock and sponge. Uh-huh. The animal is a snake. The country is Syria. The plant is sage. Do you know sage?
No. Sage,
yes. A kind of like this. When we boil tea, we put it into tea to give a new flavor. Delicious.
Yeah.
It's very healthy, isn't it, sage?
Yeah.
We have a sage plant at home.
Yeah.
We do, yes, child, we do. And we use sage when we've got a sore throat. It's supposed to be good for when you have a sore throat.
That's right. It's good for your whole, like your throat and your chest, yeah. Everything, isn't it?
Yeah.
What's sage called in Spanish and Portuguese? I can't remember. Is it salvio? Do you know sage, Conrado, in Spanish? No. What's it called?
In German, it's salbei, and in Latin, it's salvia.
I think it's called that in Spanish, isn't it? Salvio?
Poppy's using the translator.
Can you show it to us again, Sahar? Can you show it to us?
Sure, sure, yes.
And then we can see.
When Martabi, yes. Like this. Can you see it in the camera?
No,
I know.
Move it.
Let me put it on the.
Yeah.
Is it clear now?
Yeah.
I think we call it erva cidreira.
Okay.
They grow it up on the mountains. On the mountains, they are in Palestine.
And this kind is the dry one.
Yeah.
And yeah. It has a season in Palestine. It has a season. When we make tea in winter, we put sage, and in summer we put mint.
Mm-hmm. I love it.
Yeah.
But do you leave it in for a long time, Sahar, the sage? Do you put it in and then leave it in, or do you put it in and then take it out?
It's okay if you leave it for a long time. It's okay. It doesn't have expiry day, but we don't buy them in large quantities.
Yeah.
I think she means when you make tea.
Do you take it out like
tea? Yeah, yeah. Till we drink it, yes. Till we drink it, yes.
Yeah.
You can put it for an hour. It's okay. Yeah. Also, it's useful when someone catch a cold. It's useful to boil it with water and put honey or sugar. But honey is better.
Yeah, it's very bitter, isn't it? If you leave it too long, it gets very bitter. I don't like it in too long.
It's used a lot for cooking with meat. It's cooked meat, isn't it? Sausages, I think.
Often with meat?
An onion with sausages.
It has nothing to do with meat, no.
No, we don't put it with meat.
In UK, it does. Yeah.
Not in our culture, but in different cultures, they use it. Yeah.
Yeah.
Maybe
they cook this with meat.
Yeah.
We use it. We use it at Christmas to stuff the turkey. Sage stuffing. Yeah.
Inside the turkey. Yeah. Yeah.
Right.
Brilliant. Raja.
I was just missing the name of the boy. So I've written Clara for the girl, cucumber, plant, closet.
Wait a minute.
Sorry.
Raja, you can't spell. The letter was S. It was S.
I thought we were allowed to choose any letter that we want. Sorry. She was much easier for us.
You are playing with different people, Raja.
Yeah. Anyway, what's the boy's name in C? A boy's name that starts with C. Do we have one?
Colin?
Colin. Yeah, Colin Farrell. That's the actor. Yeah, okay. So it's my turn now. Okay.
Before your turn, the marks, the grades. My teacher didn't give me a grade.
You are the best, Sahura.
You
are the best. You have finished first. and you know always when the electricity or the power is cutting off, families were sitting in circles and they play like such games together and they have fun together, because you know it like enrich the children memories and helps them to do lots of things, like doing a game,
right?
And
yes,
that useful game.
Yeah,
that's right.
Having fun together. Yes.
Yeah. I play this game at Christmas with my family, but we do it where you try and find the most obscure one that nobody else will get, and then if you got a name that nobody else has got, you get 10 points. If you get a name that somebody else has got, you get 5 points. So you have to think of like really obscure ones that nobody will get. Yeah.
That's right. We have the same here. Family. We have the same grading rights. Yeah,
that's right. Yeah.
Well, I got Somalia for S. Did anybody else get Somalia?
No. Oh, Switzerland.
Really, Conrado? That's because we're our brains are so
connected.
Yeah.
Okay. I get zero for all these things.
Yeah. Did anybody get salamander for animal?
Oh, no. Salamander, yeah.
Oh, we saw a salamander, didn't we? On Thursday.
We learned about salamander last Thursday. Yes.
Yeah.
Tiger salamander.
Tiger salamander, yeah.
Salamander. Yes.
Okay, brilliant. So now should we go to, where should we go now? Oh, we're going to Raja. Raja. Yeah.
Okay, so I know you've seen this a lot, and Sahar spoke about it at the beginning. She spoke about a little bit of embroidery. So I'm obsessed about embroidery. I like it. Like, we started with making these dresses, like the Palestinian dress.
Beautiful.
Yeah, it's like
all over.
Yeah, we have different patterns, different colors of it. Like each city or each village has its own pattern or its own colors. And this extended now to make more things with embroidery. So now we have some accessories. Can you see them? Like rings?
Uh-huh.
Yeah. Like... what do you call it? Bracelet or something? Yeah. Yes. And a necklace.
Bracelet, yeah.
Mm.
Yeah.
Well, it's a
now people just add embroidery to every single aspect of their lives. You can find glasses. They're not made of silk or something, but the print on them is like embroidery. We have like where we put... tissues, like the bucket where we put tissues, we have it like embroidered. So people just started to add embroidery to every single aspect of their life. And I have something here to show to Sue. You remember this, Sue?
Yeah, yes, my hand.
One day. It's going to get to you one day. So guys, Sue asked me to buy her this bag.
It's beautiful, yeah. Oh, yeah, beautiful.
And I bought it since how long? It has been
months ago. Yeah, yeah,
we're just waiting for Nick to come to Gaza and get
one day. Her. One day I will get it.
Yeah, you will definitely. So this is Sue. It's waiting for you. I have it like in the closet, just waiting for you.
Oh, thank you.
I also want to share with you some Palestinian other things that men typically wear. It's like you know them already. Kufiya. This is the black kufiya. It's my favorite. We have different colors. We have like the black, the green, the red one, based on the colors of the flag that we have, our flag. So this is the black one. Can you see it? I like it more. It's my favorite. And I have also the red one. So that's the red one.
Red one, yeah.
Yeah. What's your favorite, Nick?
Well, I like the red one because I wear the black and white one nearly every day, so...
Yeah, you need a red one, right?
I need a red one. I have
the red one.
Yeah.
We have a green one, but I don't have it now. So basically, that's
this one as well. Yeah.
Oh, that's nice. That's all different colors.
Yeah.
Oh, I have me too.
Oh.
Oh, you've got one too. Wow.
This is red. Is it red? Yeah. But I use in my.
It's like something
using
like
this form, yes.
Yeah.
Yeah.
In this part, I use in this part usually.
Uh-huh.
Mm-hmm.
Like a scarf. Yes.
Is that made in Mexico, Danny?
Yeah.
Is that made in Mexico?
Yes, of course. Yeah, in Mexico, sometimes I use in this part.
Mm-hmm. Beautiful.
Yes.
I've got a question for Raja. Raja, can you explain what each of the different parts of the keffiyeh mean?
What do you mean?
Don't they have different meanings? Like some of the patterns represent different things. Like all
nothing. I just believe there's different patterns, but they're very similar. But this one is the most official one because it's worn by our late president, Yasser Arafat, used to wear it a lot. So this is the official one. So people just got started to put colors. So they put red and green based on the colors of our flag.
Yes, so the red one has narrow squares, but the white and the black one has white squares.
That's right. Yeah,
that's the difference. You can see it's like different pattern, that one. Yeah. And the black one has much more maybe spaces between the buttons.
Yeah, white. Yeah, it's lighter.
More, I think that the red one is for the whole, the all Arab people. If you see anybody who is wearing the red one, that means he is Arabic. But if you see that the other color, that is
the Palestinian. Black is for Palestinian, yeah, it's more global for Arabs.
Yeah.
The red
one. All right, yeah.
But the black actually, this is the official one.
Yes,
that's the one. This was given to me in...
That's the official pattern now, yeah.
This is the Hands Up Project, Kufiya.
Yeah.
For the Hands Up Volunteers, it's official.
Yeah.
The one in New Zealand, yeah.
Great, that's brilliant. Do you want to go next, Sue, since you're there?
Yeah. So I've just brought along something about my hobby. So when I think of home, I always think about my mum. And when I was about 10, my mum taught me how to knit.
Oh,
it's really nice that you've talked about the embroidery because, so when I was about 10, my mum taught me how to knit. And then I didn't knit for years and years and years and years. But then when lockdown came, I started to knit again. But I started to knit different things like dolls. I didn't knit clothes and things. Usually people knit clothes, but I started to knit these dolls. And I knitted. So this was the first one that I knitted.
Wow.
So do you know who this is?
I do.
Anybody know who this is? This is Greta
Thunberg. Poppy knows.
And she's a famous girl that... she fights against climate change, and this is her famous thing that she writes on her placards, Skolstrek for Klimatet. So do you know what language this is?
No.
Swedish.
Because she's Swedish. Mm-hmm. Yeah, so that's Greta Thunberg. So that was the first one.
Wow, that's brilliant, Sue.
And then I made this woman. Do you know who this is? This is Frida Kahlo.
Frida, yes.
She was a famous artist. So can you see the flowers?
Oh, the details, lovely.
Well, she's Mexican, isn't she?
Oh, sorry, yeah, Mexican, yeah.
Mexican. Yeah, no, I'm just thinking, because Danny and Gabriela are from Mexico.
This was her famous thing, Por La Paz, yeah.
I love that she has accessories.
These are all women that I really admire. So I knit people that, you know, I really admire. So I love Frida Kahlo.
Yeah.
I love her accessories. And then I put some earrings on her.
Yeah, accessories. I just love them.
Is she still alive, Frida Kahlo?
No. I'd like to go to the museum in Mexico about Frida Kahlo. Yeah.
Mm. Have you been to that museum, Danny?
Yeah, in Culiacán. Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Oh, great.
And then this is a famous British Indian woman who led a group of factory workers, who she fought for better conditions for a group of factory workers. And this was her famous saying. She said, "We are the lions, Mr. Manager." Yeah, and she was called Jayaben Desai. And she was an Indian woman. So she's my hero as well.
Wow.
Yeah, you know this one.
Yeah.
This one is Ahed.
Yeah.
Ahed Tamimi.
Can you tell...
She's my hero as well.
Can you tell us about her, Sue? Because some people might not know.
Yeah, so Ahed was a child prisoner. So she was she 15 when she was arrested? She was arrested She was arrested in her village.
Yes.
Soldier came on her up the drive to her home. She was arrested, yeah. So she was a child prisoner when she was about 15.
Right, yes.
And she's a symbol of young girls' struggle in Palestine. So I love this one.
That's good. She's wearing kufiya.
Hair is made from
hair, yeah.
curly. From some very curly sheep in Cornwall.
Yes. The green eyes, yes. The green eyes.
I made a few of these. People asked me for these.
No, brilliant.
I made a man. I made an old man.
My favourite.
Bernie.
This is Bernie Sanders, an American politician. And this was the way he sat one day. And the way that he sat. And he's got very famous mittens.
Gloves, yeah.
He's got white hair. So that's my hobby. So when I think of home, I always think of my mum. When I think of my mum, I thought of when she taught me to knit when I was 10.
Wow.
I enjoy it. It's a nice hobby.
Yeah, I'm sure it is. How long does it take you to finish like a piece of them?
So our head takes a bit longer because she's got the hair takes a longer time. About 2 weeks.
2 weeks, yeah.
About 2 weeks, sure.
Oh my goodness.
Do you just make one of them, Sue, or do you make more?
No, so I make one and then people might say, oh, can you make me this one? So then I...
Yeah.
You should be start charging people.
Yeah.
I get people to make a donation, then I give it to some charities in Gaza.
Wow, that's lovely. Yeah.
Brilliant.
I like this one. I've always loved knitting.
I've always loved knitting, but I've never was, like, good at it. I just...
Yeah.
People say, why don't you knit clothes? I say, no, I like knitting dolls.
It's more creative to make dolls.
I can knit clothes, yeah.
That's
lovely.
Shall we go to Gabriella? Do you want to show us something, Gabriella? Show us something about your home.
Yes.
Brilliant.
Would like to tell about this traditional craft. It's a doll and it's handmade. They are made of cloth.
Cloth. It's beautiful.
What's her name?
Yes.
Can you show it right to the camera? Can you show it to the camera? That's it, yeah. Wow.
How long do you have it? Since when do you have it? It's very nice. It's very beautiful.
7 years.
Seven years. Wow, that's a long time.
And it's handmade, did you say? It's handmade?
Yes.
Yeah, somebody made it. It's beautiful.
Really beautiful. Is it a traditional Mexican
dress?
Clothes?
Yeah.
Yes, okay. It's really lovely. Gabriella, is your mum or dad with you?
Yes.
They are. Do they want to say hello as well? Or not?
Hello!
Hello! Hello, that's great that you woke up really early to come and join us today.
Yeah.
Okay, brilliant. So we're going to go to...
Conrado, who's going to break Conrado. Up and your relationship with him. Because
why?
You left for the last...
Oh, he'll forgive me. Conrado will forgive me anything, won't you, Conrado?
What? Forgive you about what?
You'll forgive me anything, right?
Yes, of course. Yeah, of course. Good. For this time, I didn't prepare anything, so I'll improvise.
Great.
I'll talk to you very briefly about something that identifies Brazil throughout the world, which is a kind of music. And dance.
Mm-hmm.
Samba, yay!
Yeah.
Yes, samba. Because, you know, for 3.5 centuries, Brazil brought people from Africa as slaves to work here in the farms and cities too. So we have this heritage, the Black African heritage, African heritage. And they brought us loads of good things. And one of those things is their music. Samba was, I think, created here in Brazil, but it got here its origins in the way African tribes go about it in life.
Yeah.
They work dancing, they live dancing. It's very important for their, for the way of seeing the world.
Mm.
So it made us very happy about things. But samba wasn't accepted as a serious music, because, you know, all the things Black people did and still do in a way are looked down on.
Mm.
We have this trouble here, as you might guess. And so it was very important because in the 40s, when President Vargas wanted to unify the country and the capital of Brazil was Rio, it wasn't Brasilia, and samba is very strong in Rio de Janeiro. So the national radio, given carnival and all those, the popular appeal of samba started playing a lot on the radio. So it sort of reached out for the whole country.
Yeah.
And in the 50s, 60s, we had a sort of sophistication of samba, mixing it with the American Black music, the jazz, the American jazz that developed from blues. So this mix gave us the bossa nova. I don't know if you heard of that, bossa nova. And it is a sort of a samba for exportation. The whole world buys it as a very sophisticated product Brazil made.
Mm. Shall we play a samba?
If I can play a samba?
Yeah.
Oh, it's very early in the morning. The others are sleeping.
Okay. Well, I mean, I could play one through the, I could just play the music, the sound of one, a video. I could play the
sound. Oh, yes. Okay.
I mean, Vai Passar is samba, isn't it?
By Chico Buarque. Well, it's very important samba, yes. This is because there are different sources of samba. Samba is the general name, but you have different types of samba. And Vai Passar is what we call Partido Alto. It's the sort of samba they play when the people are dancing in the street for carnival.
Okay, so as it is kind of carnival today, it's Easter Sunday, and this is a carnival piece of music. I'm gonna play a samba, and shall we all dance? I know it's early in the morning, but shall we dance samba?
Yay!
We better listen to this. Can
you move your hands, no? And maybe yes?
Dance with your hands.
Yeah.
Okay, so here is a a samba that I really love. It's called Vai Passar, and it's actually, it's about the dictatorship, isn't it, in Brazil?
Yes.
It's about saying it's going to end.
Yes, yes.
The dictatorship will end. And it did. But then another one came, maybe.
Yeah.
Anyway, we'll not get, we won't get too political.
Talk about Bolsonaro. No.
Yes.
Yeah.
Well, I saw a movie about the samba. It's very interesting, but I don't remember the name about the movie.
Writing's not that easy. Very interesting. Grammarly.
Sorry.
Can help.
Sorry.
This sentence is grammatically correct.
Danny was talking.
Yeah, sorry, Danny. What were you saying? Yes, there's a movie about samba.
Okay, don't worry. It's okay. So I saw once a movie about the same. I don't remember about the name, but it's very interesting, the movie. I don't remember in this moment the name of the movie, but it's very interesting.
Is it about a Brazilian movie?
About the samba, yeah.
Oh, okay.
Well, yes, it's the samba with jazz. It's very interesting, the movie. I don't remember in this moment the name, but it's nice.
Yeah, oh, well, I'll try to find that. We'll try to find it. Okay, so it's time to dance now. It's the end of the session. It's been lovely to meet everyone. And I hope we can do this again sometime. Thank you for sharing your homes with us. And now we'll hear Vai Passar, and we can dance, we can do whatever we like.
Turn off your cameras and dance.
Turn off your cameras and dance, yeah.
Yeah.
Vai passar nessa avenida um samba popular. Cada paralelepípedo da velha cidade essa noite vai se arrepiar. Ao lembrar que aqui passaram sambas imortais, que aqui sangraram pelos nossos pés, que aqui sambaram nossos ancestrais. O tempo, página infeliz da nossa história, passagem desbotada na memória das nossas novas gerações. A nossa pátria mãe tão distraída, sem perceber que era subtraída em tenebrosas transações. Seus filhos erravam cegos pelo continente, levavam pedras feito penitentes, erguendo estranhas catedrais. E um dia, afinal, tinham direito a uma alegria. Chamava carnaval, carnaval, carnaval. Vai para a sala dos barões amigos, o bloco dos Napoleões retintos.
When the last time you danced, Nick?
I was at school 5 years ago.
People dance all night long.
Yeah.
Well,
he does dabka.
It's a lot of exercise.
Yeah.
You are professional about the dance.
I can't do it any longer.
Lovely. Well, it has no particular moves. Just wave your hands and just like that.
Yeah. That's it. And your hips.
What do you mean? Your hips. No particular moves. Conrado, we're professionals.
Yes.
Only you move your hands and your hands.
Yeah.
Only your hands.
Your hands and your hips.
Okay.
I'm not very good with my hips.
It's nice. You are the professional.
What's the dance called in Mexico? What's the traditional dance in Mexico?
Oh my goodness, it's a lot of the music, but in especially about the oh my god, mariachi and salsa. But I don't know salsa. Mariachi only you move your but the salsa, well, give me a moment for in this moment in the music. Mariachi is nice, yeah, mariachi is nice. But the cumbia, I don't know. Cumbia, I don't like the cumbia. So in my case, I don't like the cumbia, but it's nice for the other people. For me, no, the cumbia, I don't like. Give me a moment. Mariachi, for example, in this part, is very, very nice.
Reggaeton. Reggaeton.
Reggaeton, yeah, reggaeton, but I don't like.
You don't like it?
No, I don't like the reggaeton. For example, mariachi.
This is salsa?
Mariachi. Only you move?
Okay.
The song El Mariachi Loco. El Mariachi Ooh. Loco.
Yeah, mariachi crazy.
Yes.
Loco mano.
Okay, we should have a bit of dabka as well then, shouldn't we?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Bring
your kids to do
dabka. The dabka is the traditional Palestinian dance,
yeah. So how about tango? What's the origin of tango? Is it Mexican?
Argentinian.
Okay.
In Mexican, no. Tango, no.
Okay.
Handbook, where are you? Were you born in Germany or you're from another place?
I was born in Vietnam.
Vietnam, wow. Yeah,
my father's German and my mother's Vietnamese, but I grew up in Singapore.
Wow.
Well, I was going to ask you about dance from...
can't tell you about any dances in Germany or Vietnam or Singapore.
Yeah, I'm wondering about dance in Vietnam. There must be a traditional dance, I guess, in Vietnam, right?
Probably one where they wear their traditional dresses and swing their cone hats.
Yeah.
You know, here in the south of Brazil have people that came from Germany back in the 19th century. So they live in cities, beautiful cities. They're very German-like.
Yeah.
And they have traditional Oktoberfest and things like that. And they're very animated.
With their dances, with their lederhosen and all.
Oh, yes.
That's right. Yeah, there's a lot of German communities. A lot of them left because of religious persecution. So they, you know, they're more conservative Orthodox Christians, and they found new homes, made new homes in Brazil.
Yeah.
Yeah.
People say that they are more German than the Germans, right? In some way, like,
but isn't that the same everywhere? That, you know, people who live, who come from a place and they go somewhere else, and they just become more, you know, like, you know, the Irish who move abroad, they're more Irish than the Irish, and the Germans who move abroad are more Germans than the Germans back home. And with the English as well, you know, you have that. There's a stronger sense of, I don't know, ethnic expression or ethnic identity.
Yeah.
Except for us, we're not more Portuguese than the Portuguese.
Maybe Nick, when he comes to Gaza and stays for a while, then he become more Palestinian than the people themselves.
Yeah.
So Nick,
How about traditional British dancing? Can you show them a video of Spanish dancing?
Yes, 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 sure, yes, Nick.
There's a traditional British dance called a barn dance, and we dance in a big circle. Lots of clapping, and that's quite fun.
You know something.
We don't tend to do it now, but in the summer we have people called Morris dancers that dance in the street.
It's very silly.
Pardon?
It's very silly.
Very silly, yeah.
But do you know, I did something interesting the other day, Sue.
Yeah.
Do you know why it's called Morris dancing?
No, why?
It comes from Moorish.
Oh, right.
The Moors, you know, the Moors who came from North Africa all over Europe and they conquered.
No kidding.
Spain. Yeah, that's where it comes from originally.
Wow.
So it's like we're not to blame for it.
You blame the Arabics.
Shall I show you some Morris dancing then? Would you like to see a video of some Morris
Sure.
We want to see you doing that yourself.
Yeah.
We need sticks and bells.
Yeah. Poppy was born in Canterbury and Canterbury is really near to Whitstable. We used to go to Whitstable every weekend in the summer. And there were a lot of Morris dancers in Whitstable. Yeah. So, like you said, with their sticks and their cowbells on their ankles. Yeah.
Very
silly.
It is strange. It's only men, isn't it? Isn't it only men who do Morris dancing?
Well, a friend of mine lives in Wales and she's in a Morris dancing troupe. So,
yeah.
All right.
But it is mainly only men.
I didn't know that you had a friend in Wales.
I don't. Wheels.
Okay, I'm going to show you then.
Share a screen. Can you share a screen with us?
English dancing, okay?
Share a screen, show us.
Silly English dancing.
Okay.
Huh. This is in Oxford, I think. When I see it now, it does seem a bit like Dabka.
Yeah.
Yes.
Yeah.
It's all old men.
It is all old men, yeah.
Dabka's young.
No, he don't does that.
But just the way that people, like, Dabka is a lot about moving your legs, isn't it? You're going to show us a video of Dabka?
Old Dabka.
Mm-hmm.
It's more like Irish dancing a bit, isn't it?
Yeah. It's basically moving their feet.
Yeah.
In a certain way, there are some certain moves that they need to memorize and just copy.
Yeah, Irish dancing's a bit like that.
No, I used to dance dubco a long time ago now. I'm not fit enough now.
Brilliant. Well, when I went to, the first time I went to Saha's school, I was
doing a
Yes.
And then Saha said to me, you need to come outside. You have to make a speech in Arabic in front of the whole school.
And there were about 50 girls dancing with you.
How did it go, the speech in Arabic?
Well, I'm not sure which was worse, me making a speech in Arabic or me dancing dabka.
I don't know which was more embarrassing. No.
What?
Both of them were excellent. Both of them were excellent.
Yeah.
Yes.
Okay.
He spoke Arabic and he danced dabka with our headmaster. It was brilliant.
He spoke Arabic.
Something that really, really impressed me about that day, Saha, was that I think you would never get that in a UK school. You had like the headmaster.
Yes.
And teachers and all the students dancing dabka together.
We have about 50 girls. 50 girls were dancing with you.
Yeah.
Do you remember?
The headmaster was dancing too, wasn't he?
Do you have a video of that, Saha?
Yes.
Was it recorded? Do you have a video of that?
Yeah, it was on my last mobile. I wish I can could find it again and share it with you.
Find it.
The day before Mr. Nick came to our school, we had an open day. And there were about 50 girls dancing dabka with their Palestinian dress as yours, Raja. And we kept them for the next day till we have a workshop in our school. And there were many teachers from Jabalia and Beit Hanun. It was crowded, but it was ordered at that time and managed. It was powerful. Mr. Nick and the girls danced together. It was excellent. I can't forget that day.
Me too.
Trying to find that video, please.
maybe on the Facebook page, we should have a dabka dancing lesson or something like this.
Yeah.
Somebody comes and teaches us dabka.
Well, that would be great. We know, you know that Ramadan, do you want to tell them about your idea, Rasha, for Ramadan?
We thought of that Ramadan is coming and so most of the sessions might take a break. So we thought of something like creative, a session that is creative, different. It has nothing to do with education, has nothing to do with storytelling. It's basically about sharing stuff that we usually do in Ramadan. Maybe the idea of cooking was there. We thought that someone could cook something, traditional Palestinian thing, and other people could join in the live session, or other people can join through Zoom as well. Two people can cook together, one from Palestine, the other is maybe a remote volunteer. That would be interesting. And since Nick here mentioned dabka, we could like have a session about dabka, maybe. And someone who teaches us how to do
in Ramadan.
That. Yeah.
In Ramadan.
Ramadan.
Dabka.
Why not?
So the sessions will take place in the kitchen in Ramadan.
Yeah.
We might cook msakhan, me and you. What do you think?
Well, dancing and eating, it sounds like carnival, not Ramadan.
Yeah.
I did a cook along last week from the West Bank. We made falafel and hummus, and that was good.
Yeah.
You just had to register, and then they sent you the ingredients, and then there was a woman in Nablus that was in her kitchen showing you what to do.
Brilliant.
Although falafel is difficult to make, so although it's difficult to make falafel, right?
Yeah, mine were a bit of a disaster.
Yeah.
Hummus was nice, but
falafel. Yeah, it's easy. Hummus is
so
easy.
Yeah.
I made shakshuka the other day.
It's not shakshuka.
Really?
Raja, and she said, "That's not shakshuka."
It's everything but shakshuka, Sahar. Tell her the ingredients.
Well, it was just a different thing. It was shakshuka, but it had beef in it.
Do we have beef in our shishmukasahar?
My sons are laughing. What?
Do we have
beef? My sons are laughing. They hear the word shakshuka and they are laughing. And we are hungry, Mr. Nick.
Yeah. Can you tell us about shakshuka?
It's very easy. Just to put, you can put green pepper and
fried
some
tomato.
Oil. Then you you can cut tomatoes and put it in the pan. Or they give water, you can put eggs into it. Don't mix them together. Just put
just
the eggs
in
to be as eyes. Oh yeah. And don't cover it. Till it's dry, you can put ground pepper on it.
And salt.
That's it.
That's shakshuka.
That's shakshuka. It's very simple and easy.
Ooh.
Ooh.
It's nothing. It's everything but shakshuka.
Anything but shakshuka. Yeah, maybe
you made shakshuka or what?
I don't know what's that. Can you ask him? It has Swedish in there.
It's got shakshuka, it's got chickpeas,
spinach,
chicken, and rice.
Don't call it shakshuka, please.
Shakshuka, chicken, and rice? That's makluga.
Well, I have a donus. In this moment, I have a donus.
It's oh, red. Wow. What's that?
Can you spotlight her?
Oh, it's a donut.
Yeah.
A donut.
Do you make it yourself?
Yeah. Very delicious too.
Mm, I tried to make them one time and they went like a disaster. It didn't work out.
Well, me too, because it's
they're ready made.
Yes, of course.
Do you use some different?
Thank you for being honest. That made me feel good.
Palestinian one, Chilean one.
Yeah, different donuts. Did you say, Sue?
No, we could do different. Maybe different Zoom sessions where we do a different theme food. You know, different cook along. Like a Brazilian, a Palestinian, a Mexican.
Yeah, great.
Yeah, that we thought of that too.
Yeah.
We could learn
that one
English one, fish and chips.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, fish and chips.
Yorkshire pudding.
We will make Nick's favorite dessert, which is kunafa. Sorry, I'm lying now.
That's my favorite.
Nick doesn't like it.
I don't like kanafa, but it's too sweet. Do you like kanafa?
It's...
Do you like kanafa, Sue?
Yeah.
A little bit.
Yeah.
It's very sweet.
Isn't it?
It's very sweet. But so,
we have different types of kanafa.
You can control how sweet it could be, like by adding the syrup. You cannot like add a lot of syrup. You just can add a bit of syrup. This is the way you can just... Okay. Control how sweet it is.
But it is delicious if it isn't sweet.
Basbousa would
be
perfect.
Sweet.
Let's make basbousa.
Basbousa.
Yeah.
You want to learn more about Palestinian food. The Palestinian people learn a lot about Western food. Palestinian people nowadays make a lot of Western food.
I want to try the English cake.
Yeah,
I've looked at it, the English cake. It has like raisin inside, dried...
fruit cake.
Fruit? Oh, Christmas fruit cake.
Christmas fruit cake,
Let's keep it for Ramadan so Nick can cook it for us.
Can you, Nick?
We're sharing experiences.
I can cook, but I can't cook cakes. I'm really
bad at
making cakes.
I cook a nice fruit cake.
I thought you baked
it. Maybe you can help us with that.
I'm good at fruit cake.
Okay, so you can tell us.
I noticed that too.
Yeah.
Poppy is good at Victoria sponge. Poppy is very good at baking sponge cakes.
Wow. Oh, you have to teach me then, Poppy, because I'm rubbish. When I make a sponge cake, it comes out really flat. I don't know what. Comes out like a pancake.
There is one thing I want you to know. People in Italy don't make pizza as people in Gaza.
Gaza
make pizza a lot, a lot, a lot. In Italy, they don't make pizza like Gaza.
Well, where every is it better? Have to, in Gaza.
Yeah, every week we have to make.
What are your pizzas like then?
Yes.
How do you make your pizzas then, Saha?
We put mushroom, we put sweet pepper, olives, but black olives, and the cheese. Cheese, yes.
Tomato.
I have cheese at home. I bought the cheese on Wednesday, and I suggested to make pizza on Wednesday. I didn't make. On Thursday, I didn't make. Yes, this is pizza. Yeah.
Wow.
Pizza we make.
This is Palestinian pizza. Yes.
That looks very yummy.
Yummy.
A pizza really, isn't it? Because
it's
just bread heated up.
Yeah.
Okay, so could you please hold that thought? We're gonna make an English cake one time. Send me this.
Yeah, I can do that. Yeah, fruit cake, sponge cake, cream cake.
Poppy and make sponge cake.
Apple crumble.
No.
Special cake for Easter, isn't there? I think it's called Simnel cake.
Yeah.
You know that one, Sue? Do you know how to make that? It's got marzipan.
I can't make that one. That's the only one I can't make.
Oh, okay.
Cake, no.
It's got marzipan inside. I love marzipan.
All right, yeah.
One of my favorite things.
Well, it can.
What about muesli? I mean, what, do I pronounce it right?
Muesli?
Muesli, yeah. Can we make
muesli? Okay.
They're called flapjacks. Flapjacks.
Winnery.
Yeah.
Oh, muesli bars. Muesli bars are flapjacks. Because here in Germany, when you talk muesli, you think cereal that you eat with milk or yogurt in the morning.
Yeah. That's what I have for breakfast every day, muesli.
Yeah. Oh, very healthy.
So
very unusual to hear a non-German have muesli for breakfast.
Show us the cheese, Sahar. So this is the cheese we use.
Now, you talked about pizza. I bought this. It's a cheese. I bought it. On Wednesday, I promised my children to make pizza on Wednesday. Wednesday, Thursday, Saturday, but then it's Sunday, and it's still closed. And here are the olives that I will make. Now my sons are fighting. They say, you brought the kitchen for Mr. Nick. The kitchen. When are you going to make pizza? But sir, I'm not going to do it to make it today. Because I'm busy, I've just arrived from school, and I'm very hungry. And you talked a lot about food.
Yeah.
I have to make something quick. But during the session, while we are here, my kids have made that, and they asked me to show it to you. It's a kind of bracelet.
Yeah.
Here, they put the colors of the Palestinian flag here: white, red, and green. I don't think if they intend to do that or it's by coincidence. They say, right, that they intend to put the Palestinian flag here.
Right.
So their mother is cooking and they are doing some artificial things.
Go and cook for them. They're going to eat, you know.
I'm not going to cook pizza today. I'll make mujaddara. It's easier.
Oh, I love mujaddara. I love that.
It's a war here. They heard me. They don't want.
Oh, they don't want mujaddara. It's so delicious, mujaddara.
Yeah, it's delicious and healthy. They would like to invite you, Mr. Nick.
Great.
What about me, Mahmoud?
Mahmoud, like Tazim Raja?
No.
He says no. Raja would like to eat pizza. It.
That's the end of our relationship.
What about me? What about me?
Mahmoud, khalas, harabatak Raja. They don't want Raja to eat mujaddara. They want her to eat musakhan. They are jealous as their mother, Raja.
Oh, they are so lovely. Okay, I forgive you, Mahmoud.
Mujaddara is not good enough for Raja. It's good enough for me, though.
Mr. Nick, if you come to our house, I'll put you here on my head. I'll bring you whatever you like. We really love you, and I consider you one of our family. No mujadara and no lentils.
No lentils. We love lentils.
No, no lentils.
You love lentils, Sandal. Like
I love lentils.
Me
too. Yeah. I noticed that you love lentils. Mr. Nick told us a lot about lentils in the past. When I tell the girls at the school that people in Europe like to eat lentils too much, they exaggerate and they know we don't like lentils, because lentils in Palestine, it's not a soup. It's something different. Maybe a soup, maybe something like feta.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Yeah.
It's delicious.
Lentil soup is so delicious. I love it.
Yeah.
Lentils. You don't like them, Poppy? You don't like lentils, Poppy?
What's your favorite food, Bobby?
Don't look at me. What's your favorite?
I don't know.
She say pizza. She says pizza.
Pizza.
No?
No, no.
Pizza. Do you like?
Poppy loves Vietnamese food.
Oh, yeah.
She loves Vietnamese summer rolls, and she loves Vietnamese soup.
Wow.
Yeah. And we have a roast chicken in the oven at the moment for Sunday lunch.
Oh, wow.
We've got some Easter eggs, Poppy. Have you got Easter eggs?
Yeah.
Yeah. I'm going to eat an Easter egg later.
Oh.
Me too.
Is it a chocolate orange?
Mint. I think this mint.
Oh.
Oh, wow. Yeah.
I'm hungry.
I'm hungry too.
That's what we do on Easter Sunday, just eat loads of chocolate.
Is that just a European thing about Easter eggs? I mean, does that happen in Brazil and Mexico at Easter?
It does
happen.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So have you got any Easter eggs?
Who, me?
Yeah.
No.
Me neither.
We have the same tradition here in our Eid after Ramadan. We eat a lot of chocolate.
Loads of chocolate, yeah.
Oh.
Yeah.
I don't quite like chocolate.
Don't like chocolate?
Why not?
I don't know.
Like chocolate.
Delicious, my goodness.
Never liked it, Lilo.
Oh.
That's strange, isn't it?
That is strange.
That is very strange.
Okay. All right. Well, shall we go and have our lunch?
We'll have some chocolate.
Yeah. Chocolate.
Yeah.
To the kitchen.
Chocolate and our chicken.
Yeah, I'm starving now.
Yeah, me too.
I'm going to go and eat my...
Shakshuka.
It's not shakshuka.
You know what's traditional for lunch in Easter?
Yeah.
Here, in this part of the country where I live, what? is to have a barbecue, a churrasco.
Oh, that's
wow.
Are you going to do that?
More hungry.
Yes. That's what I'm going to have.
Brilliant.
Barbecue. Mm. Nick, you always say this. We need a feature for Zoom so that we can pass things. And
Yeah. I mean, barbecue in Brazil is amazing. When I went to Brazil, I was amazed the first time I saw a barbecue. I mean, a barbecue in England, you have more pieces of meat.
It was sausage.
Brazil, it's like...
steak.
Like an elephant.
You know, they count when you're going to buy the meat. They say, well, half a kilo for person.
Ooh.
That's the count, you see, for you to...
Half a kilo?
You cook half a kilo for each person.
Wow.
It doesn't mean that you eat that, but that's... That's you.
We can eat that.
What you have available for eating.
Sahar, we can eat that. We can eat half a kilo or even a kilo.
Can you, Nora, together, me and you can eat half a kilo.
No.
Now I'm so hungry. I'm going to eat a kilo.
Well, I always say, if you're going to go through all the fuss with the charcoal and the fire and the smoke, what's the point of just cooking a sausage each if you've got four people in your family?
That's so, precisely totally, that. Yeah.
Half a kilo, totally. We had a barbecue last week, I think on Wednesday.
And it was yummy.
It was yummy. We had lots left over, but we had enough for two meals after that. So
yes, that's what, yeah. That's what happens here.
Yeah.
There's something about cooking on a real fire as well that's lovely, isn't there?
Yeah.
Yesterday I went to my brother's house and we just sat around the fire and just looked into the fire and talked, and it was just really lovely.
Yes.
Yeah.
It's much more delicious.
Have you roasted potatoes?
No, we didn't actually cook anything on the fire. We just made the fire to sit round, because it's actually quite cold in England at the moment. It's strange. It's really sunny, but it's quite cold. Is it cold in Manchester too?
Yeah. It's -2 here.
Really?
Wow.
It's very strange because it was 17 yesterday.
Wow, that's a huge drop.
Celsius.
Gosh.
So spray and -2. We had snow last week on Saturday, which was very bizarre, which was really, really bizarre. We had like 5 minutes of sleet and snow and hail. It couldn't decide what it wanted to be. So we had all three for about half an hour.
Wow.
Yeah.
All right. Wow. It's quite hard to end this session. It's been really lovely. I love it when everything.
Yes.
But we all.
I don't want it to end.
Yes.
Funny how we always end up talking about food.
Must be the time.
Yeah. Okay. Yes. Brilliant.
Must have been the dance in there.
Yeah. Yeah. All right. Well. Lovely to see everyone. Happy Easter. And
Happy Easter, everyone.
Yeah, thank you.
Bye-bye. Thank you. Take care.
Thank you so much. Thank you.
Bye.
Bye.
See you. Thank you.
Bye.